Now, I've done a lot of videos about relationships, but let's talk about some hard shit now. If you really love somebody, you have to be willing to let them go. And so many different relationships I have seen around me and even been involved in myself have in some way gone about in a controlled sense, wherein there's trust, sure, and there's to a point freedom, but both sides are worried about the other going away, so they spy, they control, they try to manipulate or find out, and it becomes an issue where their fear about what each other could be doing creates tension, mistrust, and deception between these people. I've seen it happen many times, where they're afraid, oh, this person will leave me, so I need to do what I can to stop that. I need to make sure they don't leave me. So they start doing things that are possessive or controlling or spying. And these become reasons for the other person for them to leave. And it becomes, as the Greeks themselves called so long ago, a self-fulfilling prophecy. In your efforts to defy fate, you wrote it. By making these attempts to control and cage, more or less, you make someone else miserable. Let's use an example that I don't mean insultingly, a pet, right? Any kind of pet. It can love you if you treat it well. But part of treating an animal well means you don't lock it up in a cage all the time. Well, it could escape, sure. But you take reasonable precautions in the sense of, you know, your doors are shut and whatever. You do the basic effort required to keep that animal there and you do what's necessary, but you don't lock it away in a tiny box. You don't control its every movement. You don't watch it 24/7 all the time. That's maddening for everyone involved. And relationships of all stripes work this way. If you have a friend, well, his happiness matters, and that should matter in a sense more than just the friendship you have. If he has the chance to move away, let's say, and pursue a highly lucrative dream job sort of thing, your first impression shouldn't be to, how do I keep him here because he's my friend? It should be, how do I help him get what he wants? Because after all, if you care about somebody and cherish them and love them, or whatever the context be for this relationship, their happiness should matter. It should matter enough that, well, you're willing to make that sacrifice, potentially, if they do leave you, right? Well, if they're not happy with you, are you going to force them to stay and just be miserable with you to make you just as miserable as them at some point? Because that's really the alternative. Do you keep them so that both of you are miserable, or do you let them go so that both of you can potentially be happy again? There's a fear, this fear of, well, change, unknown, being rejected, this fear of the bad things happening, making the bad things happen. And don't fall into this trap. I could call it a cycle, but it's a little more sudden than that, where as soon as you let those doubts begin to creep in your head and you act on them just once, you give them a form, you give them a voice in your head, and then all of a sudden, because you checked once and saw no evidence, if you can't let it go at that, well, then you're suddenly, well, maybe I didn't see anything because I didn't look at the right time. Maybe I just have to look again. Or maybe I just have to listen on what they're saying. Or maybe, and then it goes from there. If you let that desire to control and that fear of losing someone hold you back, well, then you become someone that they want to leave. Just something to think about.